Our reporter Helen Mulroy is on the A14 now. Hi.
Yes, I'm here in a very blustery Swavesey tonight at one of the main nerve centres of the A14 upgrade. This project, the largest of its kind in the country at the moment, is of course upgrading one of the most vital road links for the east of England.
So where does this leave us going forward?
Well, of course, it's all about investment, and we must remember that there's a housing crisis going on in this country. Of course, that affects what money gets spent on repairing older stock, because there's continuous pressure to build new social housing.
So as you heard there, wildlife is in danger in this hot weather, but pet owners really need to be mindful of the safety and comfort of their animals in these high temperatures. Beth Keir joins me now. You're a behaviourist here at Battersea Dogs and Cats Home. We're joined by also by the lovely Poppy.
Campaigners fear rents will rise and their livelihoods will be at risk. Helen Mulroy reports.
Yes, we're here in Bethnal Green, where there are just some of the near 4,000 railway arches that Network Rail are proposing to try and sell off by the end of this year. Well, many of the businesses, like this one that we're here to see today, have seen rent rises over the past couple of years, which they believe are linked to this proposed sale and the value of these plots of land. Lenny here runs Rosso Corsa. It's a mechanics firm.
Our reporter Helen Mulroy has been at the scene for us for much of the day, Helen.
I am, Asad, yes. I mean, many employers would have heard the excuse of car trouble when employers are late for work or they don't show up at all. But as you can see, the sinkhole behind me really brought a whole new meaning to that phrase.
After recording one cyclist speed through at more than 30 miles per hour, Helen Mulroy reports.
The reality is Hyde Park has to cater for a range of different users, from pedestrians of all ages to leisure cyclists, as well as commuters.
In contacting the government, we asked the Department of Health and Social Care what they're doing about the lack of appropriate care home places.
In two-thirds of boroughs, an average two-bed flat costs more, as Helen Mulroy explains.
The Help to Buy ISA was introduced in December. It allows first home buyers to put their deposit in a tax-free savings account, with the government topping up those savings by 25%, up to a maximum of £3,000 when they buy their first home.
Violence had doubled at the facility since 2015.
The report stated that the prison was suffering under what it described as the ravages of the epidemic of drugs, and claimed over 50% of prisoners said it was easy to get hold of illicit drugs inside the prison. Figures compiled by Save the Children show that 174,000 mums in London want to work but can't get the childcare that they need. That's almost half of all the out-of-work mums in the region.
Church Row, it was demolished in 1935.
This was really a home for famous residents.
Yeah, I mean, you had Edwin Baxter, who was the coroner of Jack the Ripper murders.
Do you know any of those Cockney slang things?
Yes.
Like what?
Can you tell me any?
Yeah.
Stairs?
Yeah. Stairs.
Up the... Apples and pears?
Apples and pears, I knew that, I've heard that. The actors know, learn the Dickie Birds. Learn the Dickie Birds.
What?
Love means learn the words.
The hand-carved fretwork interior of this house was the life's work of artist and poet Hadambi Asalache.
This started in the mid-80s. He bought it, and it was in a really, as he'd say himself, parlous state.
Today they've got a very important and festive job to do.
Putting the baubles on the Christmas tree. Baubles. I got glittery ones.
From the tree alone, it's clear today's visit has been a huge success.
The lead up to Christmas is always a busy time for London's ambulance service, but already this year, last Friday, they had more than 6,000 calls. To put that into perspective, it's a 24% increase from the first Friday in September this year.
Next, it's on to Victoria.
We've just received a call that there's a 40-year-old male who's just fallen over, hit his head.
Strength training and then yoga, taking up the best part of your Sunday. But for those involved, it's all worth it.
I feel this is a much more productive way to spend my Saturday. I really enjoy working out with everyone here.
For Sylvia and Dennis, living with dementia makes everyday tasks difficult.
You like doing your council tax and getting the rent, and they ask you to keep repeating it.
Good morning from BBC London News. I'm Helen Mulroy.
Well, history was made at Queen Elizabeth Olympic Park today, and it's all to do with cycling. Sarah Orchard can explain. She spent the day at the velodrome.
A 29-year-old man has appeared in court accused of attempting to murder a man by pushing him in front of the path of a tube train on the westbound District Line.